Have you ever wondered about the impact of adverse drug reactions, or ADRs, on our communities? Let's delve into the world of ADRs, a silent epidemic that's affecting millions globally. ADRs are unintended, sometimes harmful responses to medication taken at normal doses. They range from mild discomforts like nausea and headaches to severe conditions such as heart problems, kidney damage, and even death. These reactions can occur in anyone, but certain groups like the elderly and those taking multiple medications are particularly at risk. The prevalence of ADRs is alarmingly high, making it a pressing health issue. They account for a significant proportion of hospital admissions and are among the leading causes of mortality worldwide. The potential of ADRs to cause harm and even death cannot be overstated. They pose a serious threat to patient safety and the overall health of our communities. So it's clear that ADRs are not just a health issue, but also a major public concern. To illustrate the effects of ADRs, consider this case study focusing on the elderly community. The elderly stand as one of the most vulnerable groups to the effects of adverse drug reactions, or ADRs. This vulnerability is largely due to polypharmacy, a term referring to the simultaneous use of multiple drugs by a single patient for one or more conditions. In the elderly, polypharmacy is common, as they often grapple with multiple health conditions requiring separate medications. The impact of ADRs on the quality of life for the elderly is profound, manifesting in physical, emotional, and financial ways. Physically, ADRs can lead to a range of symptoms, from dizziness and nausea to severe reactions like organ damage. These reactions can exacerbate existing health conditions, leading to a downward spiral of declining health. Emotionally, the fear and anxiety of possible ADRs can lead to treatment non-adherence. This is a significant issue, as skipping medications due to fear of side effects can further complicate health conditions. It's a no-win situation that leaves many elderly individuals feeling helpless and trapped. The financial toll is just as critical. The cost of managing ADRs can escalate rapidly, from additional medications to manage side effects to increased healthcare visits and hospitalizations. For many elderly individuals living on a fixed income, these costs can be overwhelming, leading to added stress and anxiety. Take, for instance, the real-life example of Mrs. Smith, an 80-year-old woman dealing with hypertension, diabetes, and arthritis. To manage these conditions, she takes 5 different medications daily. But the interactions between these drugs led to an ADR that caused a severe kidney problem. The result? Extended hospital stay, additional medications, and a significant dip in her quality of life, all due to an adverse drug reaction. This case study underscores the significant impact of ADRs on our elderly population, a group that is often overlooked. It is a sobering reminder that as we strive to treat health conditions, we must also be vigilant about the potential risks and drawbacks, particularly for those most vulnerable in our society. The effects of ADRs on our community are profound and far-reaching. We've explored how they pervade our lives, how they influence the well-being of our elderly, and ripple through various sectors of our society. It's clear that understanding and addressing adverse drug reactions is not just a medical concern, but a social one as well. The need for further research is evident. We must delve deeper to comprehend the full scope of ADRs and their implications. It's equally crucial to improve medication management, ensuring that each individual receives the right treatment at the right time. But perhaps most importantly, we must raise awareness about ADRs. Knowledge is power, and the more we understand about these reactions, the better equipped we are to prevent them. By acknowledging the impact of ADRs on our communities, we can take the necessary steps to mitigate their effects and enhance public health.